Masaki Kobayashi was at the peak of his career by the time he had made Kwaidan in 1965. The film can be considered as a bit of a departure from Kobayashi's normal style of making contemporary, hard-edged social commentary, as are his most of his films. Kwaidan is based on stories from Lafcadio Hearn's collections of Japanese tales, mainly Kwaidan stories and studies of strange things, after which it is named. It gathers a collection of four separate and unrelated stories that are to do with the uncanny and the supernatural, ghost stories. Kobayashi's aesthetic approach to Kwaidan was to embrace the artistic heritage of Japan, as particularly the imakimono paintings of the time. Kobayashi accomplishes this goal with a variety of very interesting and exaggerated camera movement, camera angles, and fluid movement that really gives this film, I think, its edge. Kobayashi's interest in ancient Japanese paintings had grown from his original desire in life to become an art historian. He later decided to become a filmmaker instead, luckily, due to the war back in the 1940s, World War II. Kwaidan manages to imitate the visual aesthetics of the imakimono picture scrolls, often by using bird's eye view to provide an exploded view of the interiors. From an oblique perspective, you would often find in imakimono art pieces. This oblique view creates a more two-dimensional perspective as opposed to parallel lines within a linear perspective that is often accustomed to the Western tradition in paintings. Oblique perspective in the Japanese tradition allows for multiple presentations of multiple views of an event or an action within the frame, whereas linear perspective in Western art allows for the subject of the picture to be located in a specific place relative to the other elements of the scene. The oblique perspective allows the viewer to assess any element of the frame that they choose. All the while, as we see in Kwaidan and in Imakimono, the viewer has a way of floating above the scene, almost like a Buddha in some way. This creates a lack of accuracy within the viewer from their perspective to a specific place in linear perspective, as you would have in linear perspective. Oftentimes, Kobayashi's high angle view has the effect of the architecture inclining into the space to sort of minimize perspective and emphasize surface design, as you would often see in Japanese paintings. Here's a beautiful example of how Kobayashi manages to implement 2D perspectives of the traditional Japanese paintings, in that Kobayashi emphasizes surface over depth by having a flat painted backdrop and horizontal lines that are emphasized by the camera angle sort of being far away. Everything sort of looks flat in this scene.